Wow, good day, everybody. Oh, wow, today is Saturday, and I hope you guys are having a what? Lovely day. My name is Stacy, and hey, I just want to sit back and do a little chit-chat with you guys, get to know you, and see how your day is going. One thing I want to ask you guys, what kind of weather you guys have over where you are? Here, North Carolina, is raining, thunderstorming. Is that going to stop my day? No. I am sitting here watching Good Morning America, which I don't own the rights to, only they do. And I'm just trying to sit back and get to know you guys. There's nobody here yet, so I'm going to say, come on in. I'm waiting on you. Right back. Peace.
The official list of guests, Archie's granddad, Prince Charles, his wife Camilla.
Basically, what I'm trying to do is turn the TV down. You don't want any copyright strikes here on YouTube. So I don't want to be like, well, Stacy, you know, you got a copyright strike because you don't own the rights to Good Morning America. I know that, YouTube. So I'm trying to turn it down to be within your standards. So, but I'll be back.
And that gesture should please some royal fans who've been feeling a bit left out of Archie's young life. But a bigger royal baby reveal is just around the corner. He's expected to join his mom and dad on their first family tour.
Oh, God.
Dan.
All right.
Well, just wait for somebody to come on in the room, guys. Come on. When I see you, I'll talk to you. Yeah, guys, I'm trying to quit smoking, so I guess I'm not trying hard enough, right? Wow. I find that you can quit anything if you try, but me, I try, and I cannot quit, but guess what? There's two ways to skin a cat, and I'll cut back. Right now, I'm on day one of my diet. This morning, I got up and I had me a cup of coffee, but I said no to the coffee. Trying not to set off the hot sweats because, guys, I'm going through premenopause. If you don't know what menopause is, most of you guys know of guys and gals. Let me put it that way because I'm not missing anybody. I don't want to talk down anyone, discriminate anyone because I'm not that type of person. But if you don't know what menopause is, it's basically when a woman period just stops and she stops from having any babies. But did you know that you could be menopause for 1 or 2 years and your period still can come on from stress and diet, exercise? Hey, your body will be like, hey, it's a good thing. I might have me a new piece of broccoli and boom, it magically comes on. Folktale number one. My mother says, oh, wow, Stacy, if you just make love to your man, he can help you turn your period on. You guys think about that. That's the first time I ever heard that. So what do you think about having sexual relationships with your man or woman, vice versa, you know, however it goes, because, you know, you have to clarify things like that. Do you think that'll help your menopause? I don't know. I've never heard of it before. But I'm a type of girl who believes in, you know, medicine, you know, you go to the doctor, you know, get yourself checked out because, hey, for me, I have to know what's going on in this body, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't want to get out there, you know, do something stupid, you know, like run and have a heart attack or something like that, not checking with my doctor. So right now, my doctor has got me on this thing because my cholesterol level is high. Well, I don't know if it's high because, you know, it is what it is because I did not fast because I did not know that I was going to have lab results at the doctor. So when I got there, I took it. Lab work came back, high cholesterol. I was like, oh my God, did you believe this stuff? Here I am, so young, you know, I ain't gonna say I'm young, but hey, I'm not a spring chicken. You guys know I'm going through premenopause. Hey, you can start as early as 20. Some people don't even have one when they're born, and somehow or another they're convinced to have a baby or whatever, and they perceive one. So with that being said, you know, what's good for me is not good for you. So, but I decided not to have the coffee and I got the soda instead. So I know there's a lot of sugar in it, but hey, at least it's a step. As long as you try, you can accomplish anything. But But me right now, hey, cigarettes, need to work a little hard on. Soda, good for right now. At least I'm not going through premenopause. Now, getting back to subject of premenopause. Premenopause is when a woman's body begins to shut down because of the fact that she's getting older in age. Now, it can start as early as I heard. I have not researched it, so like some other people have. But I researched for what I've done. It says about, I think, 25, you know. But here I am. And I thank God for my age. Tomorrow, July the 7th, I'll be 48. And I have two beautiful daughters that are grown, and I have two grandkids now. So, but I realized that, you know, listen to my doc. She says that you can go through menopause, and you really are not really off menopause until a year to 2 years. And I was like, what? Are you serious? She's like, yes. People don't know that. And I said, well, you know what? I'm going to take it and pass along. Here I am in my period. You know, little kids in here, hey, you know, it's ask mom and dad, but you shouldn't be in here because I put the age restriction. But, you know, menopause starts at around 25 or even earlier. But for me, it started at 47. I was like December of last year, boom, I was like, my period, what's going on? I went to the doctor, I thought I was pregnant, you know, the test came back, you know, and still not pregnant. I was like, oh my God, what's wrong, you know? And I didn't know because my mother was the type of mother, like, I ain't gonna talk about it because you're too young and ill right now. And, you know, that's how she was about it. And most women that are in her age, 60 and up, believe that, you know, you're not supposed to talk about it. But, you know, I'm a mover and a shaker. I'm gonna talk about it because I want my daughters to know that, you know, what did mama do? And, you know, that's just me. But like I said, you know, your period has to be gone out 1 year, 1 to 2 years, and then you really are in menopause. And before that, it's called premenopause. Honey, don't get me to lie to you. They say that all women go through this all different. Maybe it is. But I'm going to tell you the things I do. Early in the morning, it is like 90-some degrees here. Early in the morning, I know that I'm going to be hot. So I already get up early in the morning, do what I got to do, and turn everything low. Eat freeze pops, drink soda, ice. So far, it's working. But Lord, I miss my caffeine. I really do. Because they say caffeine and all that triggers hot flashes. Cigarettes do too, so. But I basically want to share all this with you because I think, you know, when you need to know something, hey, just put it out there because you may have somebody along the way. You know what, guys? I'm sorry. I got to go get me some coffee. So, y'all, I'll be back in 2 and 2. Hey guys, I just thought maybe I would bring you in here with me so you can see exactly what my day consists of right now. Like I said, you know, I'm going through that thing, the change of life or whatever, but hey, it's nothing to be scared of. And I started drinking sodas or whatever, but this morning I want me some coffee, guys. I really do. I'm going to pay for it later because I know I'm going to sweat, but hey, this is what I do. I'm going to make me some coffee. Now, I may take this video and edit it and I can do, you know, just how-to video, but today it's going to be just what it is. Hey, y'all, we're getting to know y'all. So, can't do it, guys. Yes, I can. Yes, can. Got to stay motivated by myself. But this morning, I'm just going to basically make me some coffee. So, Lord, the hot sweats, I can feel them coming on. But you know what? It is what it is. All right. How I make me some coffee. Oh, my God. Jesus, bear with me, Lord. I am pretty much going to make some instant coffee. And I like Folgers, as you can see, Folgers. And basically, I have a 5-cup coffee maker that I got from, of course, Black & Decker. You know, you can get whatever you want. But as you can see, I'm going to make me some coffee here. I basically just take my little thing. Well, I'm going to put it in my utensil. And I just put the water to 5 max. You may do it your way, but this is how I do it. Just basically pour the water inside the coffee container. And I'm going to take 5 tablespoons of coffee. Okay. And sometimes I may add just an extra one for a rich flavor because, you know, people like coffee different ways. I like mine strong with black. Sometimes I may drink it black. Most of the time I put sugar and cream in it. But in this morning, it's going to be sugar and cream. Now, you guys see, I need to lose 20 pounds. I'm working on it, guys. You know what I'm saying? So, but I will tell you this. I was weighing 180. You guys probably see my last videos. From the previous channel, I kind of wish I didn't delete it. You know, those are just afterthought thoughts because once it's done, it's done. But I'm weighing 145 pounds now. I am happy about that because, you know, I didn't really get into really a serious workout program or whatever. I just went walking because of my ankle or whatever. But it's getting stronger. The doctor has me on calcium pills right now and because I had a broken bone. And of course, I'm getting a little older, but, you know, I'm okay with it. You know, a lot of people get this complexity, like, oh, God, I'm getting old. What am I going to do? Hey, I grow old gracefully. Hey, I thank God for what I have. But I ain't got it. I don't need it. You know, and that works for me. But getting back to the coffee, I like Folgers. Hell, you know, being retired from the military, you know, it is what it is. I've learned a lot, you know, a lot. I guess like a lot of things, you know, Folgers coffee, sometimes Senka, you know. Hell, sometimes you don't get any coffee, you know, when you was in the military. But, you know, long story short, I'm beginning to adapt back into the civilian life again. I don't know what, you know, the future holds for me right now, but I know I'm optimistic about it. Some things I want to talk about here are, you know, people get on here for a lot of many reasons. And, you know, it is what it is. At the end of the day, you know, you can pretend to be anybody. But me, I like to keep things simple. You know, to the point. Editing, yeah, I'm going to get into it. But today, nah. I just want to relax. I got homework today. I'm trying to learn to discipline myself to get back into doing college homework. I successfully did 50 credit hours, you know, for my semester or whatever with college transcripts and just doing a lot of CLEP tests. If you don't know what CLEP test is, guys, basically you could go on to a site and you could test out with the knowledge that you do have. And so, yeah, I'm happy. I got 50 credit hours doing a great thing, and I switched college just to another college. You know, I'm not very comfortable about telling, you know what college I'm going to right now because of, you know, the situation and all the things that's going on in the world right now. So you have to stay security at all times, secure-minded, because if you don't, then one slip up, you know, and boom, there it is. You know, you're compromising your integrity and how they say it nowadays. You get cyber-stalked and all these things. I mean, you know, there's ways to protect. It sounds dumb. It probably is dumb. If it's too good to be true, then it probably is. So no matter what, you always got to be around your surroundings.
You have got to know exactly what to do, when to do it, you know, but at the same time, just have fun, you know. A lot of people make sit here and say things, well, I'm not going to do this and not do, I'm not going to do that. And I'm learning to say what I'm not going to say. Give me just a minute. Excuse me, guys.
Hello? Hey, honey. Yeah, I'm fed the dogs and finna make some coffee. Lord knows I don't need it, but I'm gonna drink it. Shit, this menopause thing is something else, but you know what? I'm gonna have my morning coffee. Now, what your ass up to? Oh. I know you talk about him all the time. Yeah. I don't know yet. Call me when you get off. I love you. Like, hey, that was my boyfriend, Ryan. He always calling me, saying he loves me. We break up, hey, he sends me 30 to 40 messages like, baby, I miss you and all that. But, you know, it is what it is. You'll get to see Ronnie when he's more comfortable. You've probably seen him on the stream before I did last night because I just took the mute and just took the mute off. I wanted him to get used to the fact that I do live because there was a couple times on the previous channel that, you know, he got on there and he's just like, whoa, you know, he just felt so free to say whatever. I'm like, no, you can't say that, you know, because I want my Facebook and YouTube or whatever I'm on to have a positive image behind it. I don't want any negativity or whatever. I try to, you know, you set an example. You know, if you can preach it, then you should, and teach it, then why not go through it? So, but anyway, but getting back to the coffee, I put 6 tablespoons of coffee because I like my coffee strong. And I like to put cream and sugar in it, as I stated before. So now what I'm going to do is let it brew. You guys can't see it, then here we go. And also want to talk about a couple of things that someone asked me before. Do I get... foghead? Foghead with menopause, guys, or premenopause. Foghead is when you get up and you're confused and you don't know exactly what you want to go and do. Of course, I get that, and I got hot flashes going on. I sleep pretty good, you know, but sometimes if I eat too much sugar or if I eat too much, you know, fatty, let's say potato chips right before I go to bed, fatty potato chips or whatever. And then I'll wake up about around 2 o'clock, maybe 3 o'clock, and be sweating. But I was looking at this lady on YouTube. I forgot her name, but next time when I research it or look at it again, I put it on my next streams. She was telling me, or you know, people she broadcast subscribed to, that basically there were certain things that helped her out, and I picked up a couple things along the way. And she said something about eating apple with peanut butter. That was a good deal. But me, I'm not that peanut butter, that fatty stuff kind of give me heartburn. So I just took some apples and I put a little bit of salt on it, you know, just a little bit because I don't take too much salt. And I ate that last night and it stopped some of the hot sweats. And I went to sleep, but of course, I woke up again 4 hours later, wanted coffee, and I didn't drink coffee and I drank soda instead. And, you know, hey, it worked. But at the same time, I'm a person who's trying to lose weight here. So I'm right now going through the changes of trying to fix my diet, listening to my doctor, all kinds of things, because, you know, the one main thing you got to do is take care of yourself no matter what. Listen to your body. Your body will tell you, you know, what's wrong. I'm constantly like dehydration and all that. I'm all into that. I understand that basically, you know, meditation and yoga and all that stuff is supposed to relieve it too. I don't know yet because I haven't tried those out, but as I go, I'll bring it to you so you can pass it on to yourself or to your daughters. You know, to any friend that may be going through it, because one thing that I was guilty of is, like, you know, I get very anxious. I was like, oh my God, what's going on? So I went up there, check a line, but it's actually true. I went to this small town that where I live from, and I said, I gotta talk to somebody. He's like, what's wrong, ma'am? I said, I feel like I'm losing my mind. He said, losing your mind? I said, yeah. So he said, come on in. He sat me down.
He said, why are you sweating? I said, it's hot outside. He was like, how old are you, girl? He was an older gentleman. I said, sir, he said, I don't care how old are you. I said, I'm 47. 47? And you hot flashing like that? I said, what is hot flashing? He said, honey, if you don't know, let me go get my wife. So he went and got his wife. And it's funny, but it wasn't funny at the time. She said, honey. And she started asking me, she said, you got a good home? Where you come from? No, this, I mean, both psychiatrists, whatever. Long story short, she said, I tell you one thing, you went crazy. I said, what is it? I can't sit down. I'm hot. I was just all over the place. So she just sat down and listened to me very sweetly as she could. And then she said, look, I'm going to tell you something here. Some of your mom ain't told you. You are going through hot flashes, menopause. And I like this, because I was like, oh my God, what? Because my mom never really talked about it. I used to laugh at her when she get real hot. She jump up and down. And any other older woman, you know, like I was in the military and there was this major in me. And she'd be like, I never knew what she was talking about. But here I am at the age of, you know, 47, about to turn 48 tomorrow. My birthday is July 7th. I'm so yeah. And I said, well, God, how can I look at this? Can I be upset about it or should I be embarrassed? And I just busted out laughing. And she said, you know what? You need to stop drinking so much coffee. You need to stop drinking so much alcohol and cigarettes. You need to quit. And I was like, oh my God, I got to quit the cigarettes. I mean, your mind goes through a whole lot of things because no matter what in life, you know, there's up and down, even with menopause, because they say about your estrogen level and all this other stuff, you know, you go through and it's like, oh my God. I mean, you never think what's going to happen to you. And all of a sudden, boom, out of nowhere, here it goes. I know back in December, I was like, oh my God, I think I'm pregnant. And my daughter said, you ain't pregnant. How many times are you going to come up here and ask me that you're pregnant? And I was like, I don't care what anybody says. I know I'm pregnant. And the whole time, I'm just about thinking I'm losing my mind or whatever. And it was just menopause. So, and some of the signs of menopause is, you know, of course, when you don't have a period. Some people can have periods and go through menopause and not know. Men go through menopause, you know, the erectional, when they're, excuse me, Lord, let me use a better terminology. When their love handle doesn't get up anymore, you know, it's called erectional dysfunction or whatever you call it. Excuse me, Jesus. I laugh about it now because, you know, you had to be there with me to see what happened because I actually thought I was going crazy. But, you know, I thank God for people like that who can pull me to the side to tell me things like that because, you know, at parents, you don't talk about it to your kids and how the heck are we supposed to know? And I'm an older kid now and I look at my daughters and I tell my daughters all the time, I say, you know, anything I go through, I'm going to share it with you regardless because you're going to have to know. I don't have a son, but I have daughters. And I tell my daughters, hey, this is this and this is that. Mom, I don't want to hear it. Well, they go to hear it because I'm going to let them know anyhow. Because when they get to the point where they got to go through the stages, I'm going through now because my daughters are, you know, like they're in their 20s, like 20. I'll tell you, my youngest, she's 25 and my oldest, she's 34. My oldest has two grandkids of mine. But when they get to the point, then they won't have to go through what I'm going through. So that's why I think it's more important for you to share, you know, whatever time you're going through menopause or whatever with your kids. So it ain't just to sit there to be mean, but it teaches them how to deal with, you know, certain things in life because some things you just can't explain. But if you share with them the knowledge that you got, then it makes it an easy transition for them. But hey, guys, my coffee's made. And I'm going to put, Lord knows, I just got to have some sugar this morning, guys. I am. Woo! I'm going to get to it. But today, I'm going to have my coffee. Oh, God. I never thought that I would get to this point where, Lord, I can't drink coffee no more. I got to watch my weight. I got to do this. I got to do that. Ooh, it just come on to you so fast. You're like, oh, my God, I'm going to get through this. But, you know, one day at a time. You know, the thing I like to go by in life is treat folks like you want to be treated. Yeah, it is. But the greatest love of all is loving yourself and all those other things too. But when you sit back and you stop running your mouth so much, like I know this and I know that, and you hush and listen and you learn something, you know, it makes you look at life differently, you know, because for so long, I'm so used to saying, move this, move that. You better left, right, and all that. But when I transitioned back, I realized I don't have to curse that much anymore. And you kind of miss it at first, but you know, as you, one day at a time, as you get there, things work out for the best. So, yeah, menopause, it is what it is, but it's not going to stop me. And I'm going to have my cup of coffee this morning. And, hey, you know, the first person that just showed up on my site, thank you. How you doing? Hope you're having a blessed Saturday. But getting back to what I was saying, you have to walk one step at a time, and surely you will get there. But I'm having a wonderful time right now at home, you know, transitioning out of the military, being retired and everything, and, you know, going through menopause, it is what it is. But if you take the good with the bad and find something positive out of it, you'll come with a great thing. And I try to be honest as I can, you know, and try to show you guys that it's not just entertainment. That's why I'm on here. It's more about, you know, becoming a friend to somebody that needs a friend. And I had two people, I guess they left, but hey, guys, you know, I hope you guys have a wonderful Saturday, because it's raining outside and I'm just making a cup of coffee and trying to set up a new YouTube channel. But long story short, I made coffee and I'm going to enjoy it. And then later on, I'll deal with the menopause. I sweat, so whatever. So let me make my coffee. One sec. Okay. I put, like I said, my coffee, I put six tablespoons in there because I like coffee. I use Folgers. And this morning, I want to do the milk, the whole milk, but I got to watch my weight. So I'm just going to put a teaspoon of cream. And if you look on here, guess what the number thing is on it in, but total carbs, no fats, none of that stuff. But anyway, moving right along. You know, you have to make choices in life that best suit you, you know. Life is too short to sit back and, you know, complain and all that, you know, be mad at everything. Of course, you're going to have mad days. We all human. You make mistakes. But as long as you recognize that you can do anything by using your mind and going for it, everything will be all right. Being optimistic. I believe, you know, positive things get positive results. And one thing about it, you know, statistically speaking, I don't care how you look at it. If you keep doing dumb things, getting dumb results, guess what? Try something new. Simple as that. I had two people. Yay! I am just so happy, you know, just to see people come on there. Because at first I thought I had to do the chat with nobody on there. Because, you know, once you put down a channel and you decide to go back and just go raw at it and just leave it uncut, a lot of people can't find you. But I had two people already in less than 30 minutes. So I'm happy about that, because my last channel, I had to sit here for two, three hours and people don't show up and boom, it is what it is. So it is, hey, that's a good thing. But I'm making my coffee. I need some sugar. How many am I going to do this morning? In this big old cup. Well, actually, guys, it's only a half a cup. And I am going to take me 4 teaspoons. It's a little bit more than half a cup. So, and a little bit more. Oh, yeah. And I will tell you guys that I do get a little nervous. I think we all do, because it's human. You know what I'm saying? That two people came on, and it's great. You know, I'm trying to, but I like to see people I'm talking to, so they're not there anymore, but I'm glad they did stop by. Well, hey guys, we're still pushing it anyway. And that's how I make my coffee. So now I'm going to go back to the bedroom. Excuse me, I didn't put the phone up, because I always leave the dog on the phone around. You don't charge it. And I want to show you guys something right quick. I'm going to grab my coffee. So hold on just a second. I'll be right back. Thank you.
You can do your thing, and no period is going to slow you down. With tampons, you get protection that goes with you for total comfort. Choose pearl for your chill, pocket for your boobs, and asset for your hustle. Do your thing with tampons.
Nature's recipe knows a dog's big life is measured in wags.
I'm back, guys. The reason why I do that, because I use that as a tool to do my editing. I close my laptop and I work back up. So, but now I'm back in my bedroom. And I want to show you the most precious thing in the world. I don't know if you guys can see it because of the glare. You can see my two little puppies outside. I had a white, like golden lab named Jacob. He passed away on last Friday because he had Pablo. And I was down about it. You know, and it took me a little while to get back up, and which I did. I buried him, you know, and I realized that, you know, bad things can happen to us all. But I look at the things I have now. I have two beautiful puppies. I still have China, and I still have Rocky. So if you guys seen my last channel, you know, before I took it down, I had about four dogs and plus two more dogs I gave away. But I still have two. They're brother and sister. They're twins. And, you know, as we go get to know each other, you know, you'll see, you know, the dogs grow, whatever.
But I just want to show you, you know, there is optimistic, even, you know, through a storm, you know, whatever you're going through, that, you know, if you wait on it, rewards, you can see. But basically right now, guys, I'm just going to chill. I'm going to enjoy my Saturday morning. And, hey, you're welcome to stay or leave, because it's raining outside, guys, and, you know, it may be gloomy outside, but it's not gloomy in here. I don't know what else I could talk about, but I guess maybe I'll just wait for somebody to show up. How about that? Oh, well, hey, I got one more thing. Somebody asked me the other day, Stacy, what do you use to do your teeth? I said, well, I do this thing, whitening thing. Hold on, guys. Be right back. That was my mother. God, I'm so lazy today. I don't want to do anything. What rainy weather makes me feel that way? Well, I guess I could get up and do something. Well, I'm just so lazy. It's okay to be like that. So, you know, it's Saturday. You know, everybody doing their own thing. Yeah, I'm quiet right now. I don't have anything to talk about, so I think I'm just going to basically turn the computer around and let you guys see what I see and go from there. I'm going to stay live all day, guys. I'm trying to get used back to this YouTube thing again, so bear with me. Wow, I'm sitting here trying not to let this coffee affect me, guys. I've got to find an alternate thing to get through this menopause, you know. You know, there was a lady named Tina Dandridge. They call her Lady D, or boss lady, kid behind the camera. I like to watch her a couple times, because you know what? One thing about Tina, she's real. I like her.
even though, you know, this is for entertainment, most people, you know, to make money, you know, those guys are big YouTubers. You know, I like her because, you know, you can be real with her, you know. I sit back and most of the time I just be in a chat, don't say anything. But I'll just say hi and I ask questions or whatever. And she's always been a nice person. Her dad was in, I think, military. I'm not going to say too much about it because I don't want her to get mad at me, you know, for putting herself out there. But, you know, if you ever want to check out something and, you, and it's 100%, I think, you check out Tina Danger. Her name is Tina D, or you can type in Tina Dandridge, D-A-N-D-R-I-D-G. I'm just guessing how to go, how to spell it. And then get behind the camera, you can see her with him. I mean, she's the character who's like, you know, she's the boss lady. That's what they call the boss lady. She watched those Country Carter. You know, he's another good YouTube guy. Like, wow. Some great YouTubers out there. And Charlie Green, Angry Grandpa, son. Interesting, you know, if you like, you know, that type of stuff. And the kid behind the camera, you know, Bridget West. They got some great things out there, YouTubers. Truthfully, Trisha, Ricky Rooney, The Rev, Tomahawk Sean. These are people that was on Dr. Phil that I have dealt with on YouTube. You know, and sit back and, you know, have my own opinion. Then I realized I shouldn't say, you know, it is what it is. They do it for entertainment or whatever. But me, I'm the type of person, I sit back and, you know, I mod people. They hope they mod me. I'm more of a behind the scenes type of person. And I'm not trying to get any kudos or talk about anyone. And, you know, that's just not myself. I try to stay drama free on this channel. I had a couple of strikes last time and it wasn't nothing big. It was like, you know, basically looking at TV and leaving the TV on and not putting in your quotes, like, you know, what do you call it? A strike for not, it was just a warning. I don't know. I got to read the YouTube thing about it, but long story short, it's like, they was thinking I was using my Jefferson, for instance, to get, you know, money from it, monetary gain, when it really wasn't like that. It was just on top of my TV that's coming in the house. So you got to state things like that, you know? And, you know, even though that it wasn't a major strike, I was like, you know, I've got to go through this, whatever. And I pulled the plug on my channel. And am I hating it now? Of course. You know, I had, you know, I was getting up there. I had 54 subscribers. Yes. Yeah, you may not say that's a lot. It's not. But to me, it was, because I don't get on here to get fame or I'm looking at this cat. Fame or fortune or anything. I just, you know, I had friends and now I can only move about two or three friends on there, you know. So, you know, maybe I'll go back and ask them, is there any way to retrieve my contacts? Because, you know, when I pick a friend, I like to keep them in my, you know, in my, I'll just say in my network, because I'm a networking type of person, because, you know, it is what it is. You know, I kind of miss them a little bit, like Miss Widow and, you know, Ricky Rev. So I hope they see me, because I didn't send any notifications out or whatever. And notifications with YouTube, sometimes you get them, sometimes you don't. You know, it's just a big old, you know, hub or whatever that goes on. You know, if you understand computers, you know it is what it is. It's not here to make a fuss or anything. But I tell you what, guys, I really do miss them. But anyway, I'm drinking my morning coffee. It's early in the morning. Yes, it is. And I'm watching this show about American videos, American most funniest videos, and I don't own the copyrights to that. And it's talking about these animals and their trip, you know, and ridiculousness. It's tongue twister for me. I like that. Some of the things I do like. But like I say, hey guys, I'm going to go ahead and turn the TV around so you can see it, but I just keep it on mute. How about that for now? Look at that big old wolf. I'm back. How was you guys' weather last night? Was it stormy, rain? Well, here it was storming like hell. Cats and dogs, man. It's like rain. You know, that's just a figure of speech, you know, that we use down here in the South, you know. But hey, it's just, it was just raining and talking about storms. Oh my God, I have never seen so many thunderstorms and people getting struck by lightning. And it was just relentless on the news. It's just like, oh my God, like, wow. But I'm happy that, you know, that we are came through another season, because, you know, Hurricane Michael and Francis, all those are pretty much impacted of us. North Carolina and the East Coast last year. So I'm just thankful that, you know, that we see another day. There's no flooding. It is what it is. So, hey, but anyway, I'm watching these two wolves on TV, and it's a trip, got my attention. And it's kind of funny, but I'm sitting here drinking coffee, guys, and just chilling. I have a dentist appointment later on this week where we're going to go in and, you know, do some things with some of the old fillings I need to get done that I had over 10 years. And, you know, you got to invest in yourself. You know, so many times, you know, we sit back and we so used to taking care of others that we don't, you know, take care of ourselves. And I said, you know, transitioning back into anything is not that hard. You got to give up something and receive something just to make that transition. And right now, this is very, very funny. Guys, check it out, the wolf. And I love dogs. I have two dogs outside, which you probably saw earlier in the stream. Rocket and China. I love them. Oh, but this bulldog just kissed this guy, Jack Hanna, on the face and left a big old swat full of globby, goopy saliva. And, you know, it's cool. You know, he's happy. That's all that really matters. But me, I like little small dogs like the ones I have. And sometimes I love Rottweilers. I mean, you know, different strokes with different folks. And I'm getting at the age, guys, where tomorrow I'll be 48. And I know you guys, what are you whining about? Hell, I'm 60 or 70. I'm not whining about anything about my own age because, hey, I thank God for it. But little did I know that I was going to go through premenopause. But anyway, you know, you got to find laughter because, you know, humor is supposed to clean out the soul and it's supposed to make you feel good. So, you know, you got to laugh through the storm. You know, when the storm is over, you can look back and be like, hey, it really wasn't that bad. But hell, I'm going to tell you right now, I remember the days, boy, when women I used to know, I was like, this is 25 years ago. I would laugh at older women because I didn't understand what it was to go through hot flashes or whatever. Hell, I still don't understand it because they say it's different for every woman. But you know what? If I can go back in time, which I can't, I will apologize to women. That shit ain't funny. And I know some young girl probably look at me like, damn, man, she just sweat like a just sweating. And, you know, and people have a complex about people talking about them or whatever. Okay, I don't understand that. But correct the criticism is what it is. You learn things through life that, you know, hey, that age just bring on. It's called wisdom. And if I could go back, like I said at the time, I would apologize to those women because you know what? Hot flashes ain't no joke. And you try to find ways and then you try to sit back and you're like, okay, if I stop drinking coffee, then hell, I won't sweat. But guess what? You guys see what I'm doing? Coffee. But I'll get back to you guys. So enjoy and watch the show. I'll be right back. wow, I got a like. Cool. Yay. I'm back, guys. I had to put something on, you know, because I'm an old Southern Belle girl who likes to, you know, not show her boobies. So, but anyway, like I said, it's a Saturday morning. I'm chilling and watching TV. I know I got homework, but hell, I'm just lazy today. You know, it's raining outside. I make no excuses, so it is what it is. But what are my plans for today? I need to do homework. I'm going to do it, but not just right now. I'm chilling, get my time to myself. Got to give yourself some me time. That is a great way to get over anything. You know, if you want to go for a walk, do what works for you. Me, I do my get up early in the morning, do what I got to do. And hey, rest of the day is mine. They say the early bird gets the worm. If that's the truth, then hey, do what's best for you. My day starts about 5 o'clock in the morning, not because of military, but basically because my mother was the type of one to make us get up and say, hey, look, you go make up that bed. You ain't getting back in it. So you might as well get up and let's get it. Get it. How she say, get to getting. So, you know, it is what it is. But, oh my God, I'm watching this humpback whale jumping over. Wow. That is amazing. Jumped over the doggone little boat, whatever. It was cute. But hey, what do you guys, what are some of your plans for today? Whatever it is, I hope you have a wonderful day. I'm going to end this stream right now, guys, because I have a couple more things I need to do. I want to stay on. I really do. Why not? I'm going to stay on. It's Saturday, right? Wow. Oh my goodness, you guys gotta see this. Watch. I don't own the rights to this, but I love marine life, biology. I do. I love the water. I really do. I guess it's the cancer in me. My birthday's tomorrow. Yay! 48. Woo! And now they've got the killer whales on there. Totally awesome. Well, I'm back. Wow. And you guys know I was talking about the hot flashes earlier. Oh, my goodness. Here we go. But, hey. It's hot, man. And they say cigarettes and coffee present. And I see that it's triggering it for me. Wow. But anyway. You know, for some things that you love, it's hard to give up. It is, but as long as you keep trying and trying, eventually you will. It's not today for me. So. I'm trying to enjoy this cigarette, but eventually, boy, I'm going to have to give them up, guys. Y'all guys got to pray for this system. When I do like this, and I'm trying to do them a little hard. So y'all pray for me, because I'm telling you. When I was in the military, I smoked cigarettes. It took me 3 days to smoke a pack of cigarettes. It did. And now that I'm home, oh my God, the fact that they're telling me I can't have a cigarette because of menopause, what makes me like, oh my God. But, you know, it is what it is. You don't try it first time, keep trying. You'll succeed eventually, right? So, hey, I'm having my cigarette. And drinking my coffee. But at least I tried. So I make no excuses, guys, really. I make none. Yes, I'm quiet. There's nothing wrong with that. I just don't have anything to say right now because I don't have anyone to talk to. But I see I got one like. Yes, I love that. Like I said before, I'm not really into having a 1 billion or 1 million or whatever subscribers. To me, family is family. You know, hey, you come on in and talk to me. If you don't like my channel, cool. I'm glad you stopped by. You like it, subscribe. We'll keep it going. Got any ideas? Come on, give them to me. Because eventually I'm going to be looking for some moderators. Right now, this channel is just beginning. You know, I'm just trying to start it all from scratch. And, you know, as I get to know people, you guys get to know me, we get comfortable with this thing. And hey, we'll start getting some mods. Can't trust everybody. So, you know, at least you can try to get to know them. Wow, I was looking at the news, and there was this young 16-year-old girl. I'm not sure her name. I may have it wrong. She's from Atlanta, Georgia, I think. She beat Venus Williams. Wow, that was truly amazing, you know, because I remember the Williams girls and their father when they was coming up. And Venus and Serena Williams, I was married to Marlon Williams from St. Louis. He states that he's canceling, but, you know, who knows? You know, I got to meet them, and it was amazing. They basically, you know, had a father that stayed on them all the time. Reminded me of my dad when I was learning how to play basketball. But I didn't choose to go to basketball. I chose the military. My father knew I wanted to be a soldier. You guys, I'm looking at this cat, man. This is some amazing stuff. Look at this. Well, it's gone now, but it's a Meow Mix commercial. And the cat's sitting here just twirling around the paper. Excuse me, guys. I got this new laptop, so I'm trying to learn how to work it. The scratching the actual paper towel was going round and round and round. It was funny. I was trying to let you guys see it, but it went off. But it's the Meow Mix commercial. I don't own it. You guys, hey, check it out. You might like it. It's funny. But getting back to what I was saying, reminded me of my father used to stay on me playing basketball. And he was like, well, you got to get up at 5:30 and, you know, you want to be the best. You do it. You do it. Do it. Now, cool. He stayed on me a lot. Of course, you know, that's what dads do when, you know, when they're involved, you know. But I chose to go to the military, and my dad knew I wanted to be a soldier because I would sit there all day and be all that you can be because he needs you in the army. And I said, hey, I'm going to go for it. And I did it. And, you know, I said at first I was going to say I was just going to stay in there for 1 year. And I was like, too easy. And next thing I knew, 10 years went by, 15. And once you get 15, like, damn, man, I should have got out. And I just stayed in it. And I would tell you it was truly, truly a great, great, great pleasure to serve my country. Sometimes I still miss it because, you know, I'm not really been that retired long. And, you know, when you've been doing something ever since you were 16 years old, you love doing what you're doing. You know, even though you don't plan on staying, it just, you know, if the, you know, time goes by, next thing you know, wow, I've been in this stuff, but it was time for me to get out. Because my time for my military obligation was over. And a lot of people say it's hard to transition. I don't think anything is hard as it is if you try. You know, there are a lot of stereotypes about military personnel that we make a lot of money and all this. And I'm going to tell you something. No, we don't. I give salutes to all the police officers and, you know, everybody that has an occupation of, you know, defending something or whatever, because, you know, it's not easy defending something that people don't understand. And people want to know what my thoughts are about Donald Trump and all of that other stuff, you know. I don't really get into politics because I'm not a politician. I joined the military to, you know, protect my country from foreign domestics. And I never knew when I was, you know, young that I would go through wars and see such tragedies and things like that, you know. And but at the end of the day, people would say, Stacey, what is it that get you through? What is your inspiration? I said, I can call on many inspirations, but the one that got me through was God himself. And they say, what? If God is my inspiration. This country was wrote on the Declaration of Independence for, you know, to defend all countries, foreign, domestic, through, you know, the right for creed, you know, sex, you know, no discrimination and none of that. And it is what it is. And that's how I stand. You know, I don't try to get on here. It's like, you better do this. No, it's your free will. Politics, religion. Hey, that's what you believe in. You know, that's what you're supposed to, that's supposed to be your core. So when it comes to things like that, you know, I sit back and listen to other people's opinion because, you know, we all got our own opinions to, you know, to do what we had to do. And, you know, nobody is in this world is exactly like people are made in their image to be themselves, of themselves, for themselves. And whatever you believe is what you believe in. But for me, God is the head of my life. So that's my that's the answer to that question. Politics or whatever it is, what it is. I could talk about it, we could do a sidebar, but as far as, you know, get my opinion about it, I think, you know, that's your free will. You know, you're here to express yourself, you know, do your own thing. I remember times I would watch my favorite show back in the day was Fred Safford. He would have a song like, "It's your thing, do what you want to do. I can't tell you who to suck it to." You know, that's how I feel about all of that. Lord, I took the Benadryl and drank a coffee, calling myself to sit back, relax, you know, and but I have allergies from here to, you know, it's just relentless. But I'm so happy that I'm not drowsy. I guess because the coffee, you know, kind of bounces out. I don't know. I'm not a pharmacist or anything. So, you know, it is what it is. I just love computers. You know, I don't just love computers, but, you know, it's just one of my hobbies I like to do. Wow. These two dogs, oh my God, they're so cute. And these commercials trip me out. But anyway. It's about time for me to get a new bed. I was thinking about getting a Sleep Number bed, but I realized one of two things. I don't have the income I used to. I'm on a fixed income. Retirement is what it is. So I've got to sit back and, you know, analyze my budget. I'm going to see a financial analyst. I heard something. I don't know if it's the wind or what, guys, but I'll be right back. I got dogs outside. I need to check on them. So, what you got? Well, I'm back, guys. It was just the next door neighbor, I guess, feeding their pit bulls. The sun is beginning to come out, guys. We might not have that much rain today. They say it's supposed to rain all day. And last night, oh my God, it rained so much. I just enjoyed it. I slept right through it. And, you know, I say the special prayer for, you know, the people out there in California with the situation going on and the earthquakes and, you know, in a time of need, like, as you know, if you can help somebody, help somebody. You feel good about yourself. And I can't believe I've been on in 1 hour, you know, but great. I'm glad I'm still on, you know, because you never know when somebody out there needs your help. And if you can, you know, try to lend a helping hand, you know, because you never know what life you could be saving. You could make a big difference in somebody's life. And one thing that, you know, that I had to go through coming home was I was trying to help everybody. But there are some people out there you can't help. You got to pray for, you know, you got to do what you got to do. But, you know, if anybody, if I got something, and I've always been a thoughtful person, you know, a lot of people, you got them from the military. No, some things are, you just was born with, and, you know, just discipline coming from mom and dad. Let's use that for an example. And I've always been taught to, you know, help your friend, help your neighbor, you know, if you can. If you can't, then, hey, you know, try to find a resource to help them out. And that's what type of person, you know, I am. There's a lot of people out there to try to scam you. A lot of people talk about you. And, you know, a lot of people try to bully you. But if there's anything out there that belittles you, honey, let it go. Save time. Save effort. And people like to take all the knowledge they got and just keep it for themselves. For what? You know, I got to understand, you know, secrecy to a friend, you know, secrecy to this. But if you got knowledge to help somebody out and it's not going to hurt you to do that or hurt, you know, let's just say you work for an organization, IBM. You can't tell them exactly what's coming out. But if you got a cup of sugar in your house or, you know, if somebody just having a bad day, smile. You know, you may not have a perfect smile or whatever, but who cares? You may have made change somebody's life forever, you know. And I think positive outflow gets positive results, you know. And I'm always been an optimistic person. And like I said, you can't fail a person out. You know, go ahead and do that. You know, you feel good about yourself. You know, if you can't, you know, hey, you just can't. But let them know, hey, how's your day going? You can change your lives, you know. And I like putting smiles on people's faces. I do. And, you know, that's just me. You know, I like, you know, giving back to something or to someone. You know, there's a lot of forms of love out there, you know. You got hateration, you know, all that other stuff. I'm not a hater. I don't try to hate on anybody, man. I mean, I may get upset some things that a person has done to me, but, you know, if it takes a little space or whatever between me and that individual to sort out our differences, I do that. But if, you know, if there's a reoccurring thing, then you have to let that go, you know, because if you spend more energy worrying about what that person did to you, you're spending more energy on them, then guess what? You're taking that energy away from yourself. You know, sometimes you got to learn to love people from a long to, meaning this. If you got to put separation between your two just to get along, then you have to do that. I had people, I mean, who hasn't, you know, everybody goes through this. I mean, it's just a part of life. You know, you have people talk about you or say negative things, you know, but if you feel that it's overwhelming for you or whatever, talk about it. Go get a friend. I mean, there's nothing in this world that should take your joy. And if you don't have a friend to talk to, hey, send me an email. You know, it's stacyrobeson27@gmail.com. I have no problem talking to you because, you know, that's what's wrong with the world. Now people, you know, sit in their house, pretend like something's not happening or they like they don't care, you know, but you got to care about something. Come on, guys. I mean, it is what it is. You can't go through this world, you know, hating people or whatever. I mean, you hate people and you give hate and the result is you're going to get hate back. You know, I know sometimes we get mad and get upset, but, you know, try to help somebody out. I bet you put a smile on your face and put a smile on theirs definitely. Change your life. But if you want to sit there and be bitter all day, that's not good for you. Try to find something positive, you know, to do. You feel good about yourself. You will. And racism and, you know, all these things and it's going on in this world. It's just lack of not knowing that individual or whatever. If you take the time out to sit back and, you know, listen to an individual or, you know, I'm watching this crazy commercial about this old guy. But anyway, these commercial things really get me. They're really funny. But if you can sit back and, you know, at the end of the day and look at your life and do a reflection, like, you know, if I can go back and change this, which you know you can, you know, what would you do to make things brighter? And for me, I say, hey, smile. It don't cost a smile that much to smile, you know. These, you know, people walk around all the time, like, you go like this, quick smile. They'll smile back. You might be like, whatever. At least you made a smile and made him, you know. So I think with that commercial guy, I keep missing it. It's a meow mix with that cat just going around or whatever. It's funny. But if you put a smile on somebody's face, do that. Wow, my coffee has gotten cold, guys. At least I'm not hot face because I got a cold in here. I know my boyfriend comes like, girl, it's cold. I need me a whatever, I'm going through eyeglasses. You know, I don't try to use the excuse, but hell, it is what it is, you know. Hey guys, any of you guys went to the beach for the 4th of July? They said there's a whole lot of sharks out there. Oh my goodness. And there's a whole lot of what do you call those little things? Jellyfish out there and all that. And there was this little girl. Oh my God, I watched it on the news. Her arm got chewed off by a shark. And I was like, oh my God, that is so sad. It really is. But her dad was punching on the, I guess it was a whale, not a whale, excuse me, a shark. It's not funny. He was punching on it, and it basically, the shark went on and whatever, and the little girl lost her arm, but she was like so optimistic. She's like, I'm not gonna let this get me down, you know. And I look up to her because, you know, you can always find something in someone that, you know, sets them above a lot of other people. Excuse me, guys, this commercial. But I looked up and I was like, oh my God, that's amazing. Because this girl, you know, she's young or whatever, but she lost her arm. She's so optimistic. And she's like, I'm not going to let this bother me or whatever. And she overcame that. So, you know, I salute that young lady that lost her arm to a shark, and her dad for saving her life. That was outstanding. So a person came by, hi, and you're gone. So, you know, I just like to address that. But my day is going to consist of I will succeed. And I gotta start watching this mammal stuff. I love mammals. But do my homework and just chill, take care of the dogs. It's raining outside. And hey, oh, three. Thank you, guys. Oh, wow. If you drop a message just saying a thumbs up, hey, thumbs up at you. You subscribe to me, I subscribe to you. I love you guys. Thanks. And, you know, I'm just trying to rebuild my channel, so I appreciate it. Thanks. Like I was saying, you know, earlier, if you can do something to help somebody, please do that. You know, you never know what kind of smile you put on somebody's face. But I'm going to get me one more coffee. I'm not too much, guys. I'll be right back. I'm just going to try to stay on a couple more minutes because I took that Benadryl for my asthma, and I'm getting a little drowsy. So, but I'm trying to stick to this new schedule I got. And I'm going to do that. I'm going to get a little bit more coffee. Be right back. So I'm back, but I want to share something with you guys. I want you guys to see my puppies. You're going to love them. So we're going to go outside. We're going to do something different here than just staying in here in this room. It's raining outside, so I want to show you my dogs, my little puppies. I have, like I said, I had a white lab named Jacob, and it passed away last Friday. So I'm just trying to, you know, be optimistic about everything. And, let me show you what's going on out in my world. So here we go. Yes, it was sunny out here.
But look. We got China. What's up, China? And we have Rocky.
See? I messed up the cage. I got to clean it out. What's up, Tana? What's up, girl?
Hey, Rocky.
It is a beautiful day out here, guys. And it's kind of quiet. It's 10 o'clock. Rain all last night. But you can see what's going on and quiet.
Say hi, China. Say hi. Say hi, everybody. Say, my name is China. Say hi, Rocky.
So, you kind of sleep, but anyway.
Look at my dogs.
I'm going back on the inside now.
Wow. Early morning, guys. 10 o'clock around here. People like to sleep in at 12. And, you know, it gets a little boring sometimes. But, hey, you can find a lot of things to do to keep yourself occupied if you want to do all that. But me, it is Saturday morning, and I'm going to be doing a lot of cleaning today, you know, from the rain or whatever. I'm just lazy as crap, guys. So I'm going to be back on today around 5 o'clock. I'm trying to get this channel popping and running. So if you have any ideas, let me know what you think about this channel. Subscribe. You like it. Cool. If not, you know, thank you for stopping by. Wow. I don't know what I'm going to do today, guys. I know I got homework to do. So what are some of your plans? I think what I'm going to do right now is make me another cup of coffee. And I feel like talking today because it's a beautiful day, you know, and it's boring outside. So I'll be back on in about 10 minutes. So if you want to come chill with your girl, Stacy, hey, let's do that. Peace.